Greetings and salutations to people of all nations. All right, so SEC Challenge. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, I am one of the judges, which is awesome. I think that's cool. We'll be. I get to watch all the videos, basically, right? So that's what I like doing anyways. I like learning from everybody. But it doesn't mean I can't participate, so that's what I'm doing. I threw this Slayer together last night, and it's MPN, so it's a negative Slayer. I guess that's kind of what I call it, a negative Slayer, because MPN instead of PMP. It's a 3055, which are pretty robust, 50K linear pot for fine tuning. It's kind of like a trimmer pot. And it works really well for me, and I don't notice any arcing. I notice that a lot of times when you have some of those resistors, like the 1-watt resistors, they start to arc inside, like when you hit a certain spot to them. So the wire spun pots, can't remember exactly their exact terminology. But I figured I should show you this. One thing that's kind of unusual you might notice back here is this deep cycle battery, which with all this white baking soda all over, has been reconditioned. And I've just, you can look up deep cycle battery reconditioning. This is like a 10, 12 year, I don't know, my wife says that it's been outside for probably five to 10 years up at her grandma's. And when I grabbed it and put a meter across it, it was like at 1.8 volts. So I didn't think it was gonna ever be even close to original. And I got it up to where it would hold a 12 volt charge for a little while, but really it stands about 11.8, which is still not a fully charged battery. But for a Slayer, it actually works pretty well, which I'm surprised about. Honestly, I did not expect it to do so well. So I'll show you what happens. This is just hooked up to that deep cycle, and as you can see, it does pretty good. I seriously am surprised how well it does. A little bit of plasma off the top. Yeah, I'm actually surprised that it's even lighting up the bulbs and sticking around. I actually helped recondition it. Well, I did it just as a quick breakdown. It was a sodium bicarbonate or baking soda, rinsed it out with distilled water, disposed of the leftover solution, which is sulfuric acid and some lead particles properly. And then I put distilled water, shook it up, cleaned it out that way. Then I put alum in distilled water, and with a little bit of magnesium sulfate or Epsom salts, and then I charged it actually with another Slayer that I had that was kind of a fail in a way. That other Slayer was kind of a fail. It just got too hot. The transistor got too hot, and it was basically the same setup, only I was using this Toshiba transistor from a Toshiba TV, and this little Fairchild transistor that I also got from Toshiba, both MPNs, both power transistors, but they just pulled too much current from the battery. So, and I didn't use a signal transistor to fire the main transistor, and didn't get into that. So it was kind of a fail, and I didn't spend too much time on it, but lessons learned there. The battery reconditioned, as you can see, it does pretty well. And so I'm quite surprised. And we can grab some of these other bulbs here real quick. Let's grab this one first. I'm trying to move along here. Not make this video too long, right? So there's not negatively coupled. Negatively coupled being me as the earth ground. But when it is, you can see some of the waveforms in it, like a spectrum analyzer too. It's kind of cool. See the orange glow from the grounding. So that's kind of interesting. Pretty nifty. You can definitely see the... I don't know, can you see it? Yeah, it's still in the screen, right? Looks like it. Right here. Yeah, cool. You can see some of the movements here. I don't know, maybe they won't show up on camera. But this one will do a better job of showing. I gotta put my glasses on for this. I wouldn't recommend this. This is just a warning to people out there. This is a UVC tube, so it can do a couple of things. One being it can give you some burns. You know, the radiation it emits, it gives you some ultraviolet light burns. But you can see the movement in it a lot better. And you can play with the plasma a little more and actually see it. And if we can do that again here, let's see if we can get it to, there we go. So you can see that it's not oscillating very well, but then if I wipe my hand across, bam, all the way across. Kind of cool, cool little thing I noticed. But another cool thing is I can, you know, kind of semi see the frequency, and there might be some calculations I can do, like a spectrum analyzer tube, to get some calculations off of that. So since I don't have any type of way to read a signal, well, I have an oscilloscope, so I'm gonna try using that later on, but I won't get too far into all that yammering. So those are two things that I wanted to share as far as bulbs, and we'll crank it up, turn it up to 11 here. There we'll go. Plasma discharge. Let's see, quite bright now. It's 24 volt now. Well, it's a little under 24 volt actually, but this reconditioned battery acts much more like a capacitor now. It's kind of cool. So it's perhaps, yeah, you should be able to see that. Oop. Off the terminals of the battery, really get some bright light. Bright light there. And the distance, not that great, even though this is a spiral fluorescent, a compact fluorescent, not that great. See if we can go over here. This is actually my Tesla coil. It's hooked up to ground. Kind of crickety. That's good enough. Sorry for the sideways, but not really getting anything off of there. But there is some energy hitting it, and to show you that, let's see. You got a nice little burn there. Show you that. So, lost my lead. There we go. So we're on. We get over here, and there's still small oscillations in the bulb. See it? Yeah. Probably can see it better in the dark. It's not very far apart. Maybe 3 feet. Maybe 1 kilometer. Or pardon me, 1 meter, 1 kilometer, sorry about that. Trying to use the metric system stateside is, yeah, it's not too bad. So 1 meter apart and a little bit of light there, but that can be far improved, and I will do that, work on that, and probably spin another. I have a little simple jig. I'll probably spin another solenoid with that. And that's pretty much it. That's my update. And now for a good test to see. We'll check and see if this is hot. Not even room temperature, so I'm liking the 3055. A tip 42C, I'd have to go PMP. A tip 31C, I think, is an MPN. I could try that too, but I'm liking this 3055 quite a bit. So I think I'll stick with that for now. So that's what I got in 8 minutes. Cool. I talked a little faster. This is the second time I've done this video, because the first time I mumbled a little too much. So I hope you guys enjoyed that, and you know, have fun, share. Let's figure some of this out, some of this wireless stuff, at least with the solid state systems. And who knows, maybe we can go on to some pretty cool discoveries as far as efficient transfer of energy and distance. That's what we're really going for, I believe. So, yeah, cheers.